welcome to a new episode of Oyster Boy Survives with me, Oyster Boy. I want to thank you for joining me today. We have a couple of announcements to make. The suit up here. So announcement number one is kind of running out of ideas for what to do with the story on this little island. There isn't you know, much land left to build on. The island is probably almost entirely hollow at this point. There's so much stuff in there. We've crammed a lot in. The neighboring islands have been remodeled, you know, with volcanoes and ghosts and moai, and remodeled the ocean floor and put in sunken ships. We're kind of running out of things we can do on this island with the castaway's story. So I have been puzzling over where to take this story next. Now, usually when I create a Minecraft world, I like to have a story, and I like to let the story dictate the building. So, typically when I'm doing this, I'm not doing it on a tiny little island with only one character. Typically I'm doing it on, you know, like, our larger continent where there are lots of characters. And when one storyline starts to run dry, I can follow another one. Here, that's a little more challenging. There is only the one castaway. So what am I going to do with his story? And I have, I think, run out of ideas. There are other characters in this this particular world. We have the scientists. They're not there anymore. But we could find out where they went. The subs that come here must come from somewhere. I think somewhere over there. So we could head off in that direction and start exploring the world where the scientists come from and start building a story there. Then there's the people who built the moai. I think they should come from somewhere over there. So we could go off in that direction and find wherever they are and start following their story there. There's also the pirates. The pirate ship sunken here, the pirate treasure here, that implies that there were or there are pirates active in this world. And we could, if we wanted to, trace that back and try to figure out where are the pirates now and follow their story. So those are three storylines we could follow, but all three of them take us off this island. The only other storyline I could think of for our castaway, Vincent, is to get him rescued. You know, I could build like a boat or a submarine out there in the water, and that would be the final episode where Vincent leaves this island. And then we could go somewhere else with Vincent and follow his life there. All of the options, though, require me to leave the island. There are no options that let me stay here. And I can't think of any other options that let me stay here. So, unless someone has a suggestion, and I know I only have like 10 subscribers, and I get, you know, maybe 2 or 3 views a day if I'm lucky. But if someone out there has a suggestion for a place or a storyline that I can pull in that allows me to stay on the island with Vincent, I think I would like to do it. However, if I don't hear anything from anyone, I'm going to have to pursue a storyline off the island. We're going to have to say goodbye to Vincent. It doesn't mean we'll be gone forever. We could come back here. You know, if something occurs to me later, you know, another element for Vincent's story, we can certainly come back here and pursue that element here. So I'm not going to be leaving this world, just this island. However, before I leave, I did think of one other nice development for Vincent's story. And that would be if Vincent gets a companion. I mean a better companion than a dog. I mean another villager. I mean, we have a shipwrecked ship. We have scientists who had to leave. Vincent's not the first person to have been on this island. He's probably not the first person to have ever been stuck on this island. So I figured, you know, after a particularly bad storm, he could come out and find that a rubber raft has washed up on the shore. It's damaged and is partly deflated, but there's a person in the raft. And that way, when we leave, Vincent won't be alone. He'll have someone here with him. And I think that might be a nice capper to the story that allows Vincent to remain on the island, but not to be trapped here all by himself. So, with that in mind, I would like to get Vincent's companion on the island. I'd like to block up the entrance to the underground resource center. That's supposed to be caved in, remember? So we'll fill that in with cobble. And then I'd like to move on. That will be, you know, the moving on part will be wherever we are in the next episode, unless I hear from you guys. So I figured out how to build a rubber raft. I figured I would use acacia wood, because acacia wood is orange. And so I was over on that island, growing a few acacia trees and farming the wood when who should appear but a zombie villager. And I was like, oh, terrific. This is the person that can wash up in the rubber raft. All we have to do is cure this person. I was planning to build some sort of a big spawning platform here. You know, it is going to have to sit here and wait for a zombie villager to appear, stick them in a boat, cure them, and then, you know, wait for the daylight and let them go inside. But this is much easier. I mean, you know, we have everything we need right here. Don't need to build a spawning platform. So, were there any other major announcements? Let's go get the stuff we need to cure this villager. And while I'm doing that, that reminded me what the other announcement is. Hopefully, the audio you're listening to is sounding better right now, because I am using some new recording gear, using a Logitech G933 Artemis Spectrum headset, wireless headset. And it does seem to record better quality audio. There's still a lot of background hiss. However, I'm also trying a new technique. Ordinarily, I would just record the audio and the gameplay via OBS. Today, I'm just recording the gameplay with OBS. The audio I'm recording with Audacity. So the voice track is separate from the game track. This means I have to synchronize them after the fact. That could be challenging. And it also means that I can wash the audio in Audacity before I incorporate it into the video, which means I should be able to wash out that background hiss. So hopefully you're hearing a much nicer audio this time around. Not as much hiss and none of that annoying clicking that was coming from my old headset. Okay, so to cure a zombie villager, you need a fermented spider eye. And I am pretty sure that the recipe for that is a mushroom and sugar and a spider eye. Yeah, there we go. There's a disgusting fermented spider eye. And then you need an awkward potion, which we may already have here. What do we got? Just water bottles. All right, so let's throw the nether wart in. So yeah, new recording equipment. Hopefully that will make the audio a lot more tolerable. I am having some trouble with the G933 headset. Haven't figured it out yet, but it seems to keep shutting off on its own. So I'll just be, you know, going along here and talking, and then all of a sudden my voice audio completely drops out, and I need to stop everything and restart the headset and then keep going. And it is not taking in the spider eye. Oh, I know why. Because you're not supposed to use nether wart. You're just supposed to use water bottles. My bad. Do that again. Right. Wait a minute, do I have Splash Potion of Weakness? I've already got one. From the last time we did this. Perfect. So I only need one. I also need a golden apple. So yeah, the audio keeps quitting. I don't know why that is. I don't know why my G933 is just stopping all on its own. It's kind of irritating. I don't know why it's doing it. All right, so we need a golden apple. Fabulous. All right. I have never tried to cure a zombie villager in a boat before. I am hoping that this works. Just to make sure, I mean, it is holding something in its hand, so it shouldn't despawn. But just to make sure I did name tag it, I called it Ugly Betty. And when it gets cured, we'll rename it Betty. All right, so let's try the weakness potion. All right, that worked. And then the apple. That worked too. Good. All righty. All right, so while Ugly Betty is being cured, we can build the partially deflated life raft. Okay, so the point of this is that the raft is mostly deflated. It's not something that Vincent and Betty can use to get off the island. And for this, we are going to need acacia stairs. Yes, I actually have a use for acacia. I mean, other than like making sticks or chests or kindling. And I'm also going to need some orange wool. All right, so, because I need some orange carpet. So let's get some red and some yellow. And then we'll mix the red and yellow. And that gives us orange. And then we need some shears. All right, so now we have our orange dye. And we have our shears. So let's go in here. And let's dye up a couple of sheep. There we go. Four. That's enough for six carpets. That's probably enough. All right. So this life raft doesn't have to be anything special. So it's pretty simple build. Well, let's go see if our villager is cured yet. Still sitting in the boat. All right, where are we going to put this washed up raft? I guess like right here. Okay, so I had figured that the raft would be, let's say, too wide like that. Except, yeah, it's going to kind of run right up against the fire. Like that. There we go. And the rest of it is flat. All right. And then the interior floor is this dark color. And then this represents the flat portion of the raft. So it's clearly damaged to the point where you're not going to get to use this again. And, you know, you could make it worse if you want. You could, like, take, like, these pieces here. And flatten that too. That's even better. Yeah. We want this raft to really be totaled. So that we can get across the notion that there's no way that they're going to somehow repair this raft and get off the island with what they have here. Now that figures, doesn't it? Alright. Okay. Now while we're waiting for our villager to cure, there are a couple of other things that I did on the island off camera. You may have noticed them already, but let's, maybe not. Let's go take a look. I felt like this island has seen enough traffic, enough people have been here, that it didn't make sense that to get to different parts of the island, you really had to crawl around on these hills, unless you were, these cliffs, unless you're actually trying to get to the top. So I widened the shore all the way along. So now you can walk just right here around the island. I think that's better. I think that makes a little more sense for an island that's seen enough human activity for there to be sort of a pathway running around the island. So that's, here it is on this side too. I also added a lip under the water. Just juts out a little bit from the shore. So this makes it much more convenient when I need to walk from the plane wreck to the bungalow or back. Right? And then over here, I boated off in that direction somewhere and visited a desert and got a crap ton of sand so that I could fill in this whole area, because we had a huge sticky outy lip here. And I filled that all in with sand to try to give it a little bit more of a natural look. It really should slope down a little bit more, but that was all the sand I could bring. All right, got our pirate boat there. All right, let's go take a look and see if our villager has cured. All right, and our villager is a nitwit. That's awesome. She's still named Ugly Betty, so we don't want her to be named Ugly Betty. She's not ugly anymore. So we'll rename her Betty, and then we'll get her out of that boat, rigging eggs, so that we can reunite Vincent. Well, it's not a reuniting. He doesn't know Betty. She's going to become his new friend. So we need a Gnome Gdeg. There it is. There's a Gnome Gdeg. And we'll go over here. And we will name her Betty. Or should we say Elizabeth? That would be her full name, yeah? Let's do Elizabeth. Okay. Elizabeth. Very good. So now we just have to figure out a way to get Elizabeth out of that boat without having her drown or swim off and kill herself. So let's go ahead and tag her with her new name. All right, Elizabeth. All right, let's get rid of this unsightly, ugly acacia nonsense. Can't believe I actually finally found a use for acacia wood. Gross stuff. Ugh. Hate that stuff. Not that I have anything against orange, but wow. That's some pretty ugly. It's just the ugliest wood I've ever seen. Whoops. Where do you think you're going, Betty? So now I have to... There we go. All right, so Betty's on the shore. Hopefully Betty won't step on the damn fire. I guess I better cover that over for now, because she probably will step in the fire. All right, let's go down here and get this loose wood. I've done it before. Ordinarily, when capturing a villager, I usually wait until nightfall to release them, because at least when it's night, you know they're guaranteed to run straight for the nearest door and go inside. Where the hell did Betty go? She's over by the house. Good. Good. I see I can't open the gate yet, or Vincent will come out. So I gotta wait till night. All right, now I don't know if there's something I should put, like, I don't know if maybe I should put a chest there to signify something that she came with, like, you know, some sort of, whatever, coil of rope, you know, first aid kit. Boy, having trouble. Having trouble coming up with the words. All right. We should probably name Vincent's animals, too. We've talked about doing that, but we've never done it. Go in here and get rid of all the junk in my inventoire. All right, there's no room in there for acacia wood. I have this chest over here. It's been like my miscellaneous chest, and it is full. So this chest will be my new miscellaneous chest. See, mop drops goes there. Dyes and stuff. Carpet goes in there. Mop drops goes there. That goes there. That goes there. Cobblestone junk. Sand can go there. Tools goes there. And the boat, obviously, goes by the dock. And then we can name Vincent's animals. We'll do that, too. I think it's fair to do that today. Where's the nitwit? Where did she go? Oh, boy. See, this is what I'm talking about. Where'd you go? Am I going blind? Where's the nitwit? Where is she? There she is, over by the waterfall. Great, that's all we need. Do me a favor, nitwit, do not go in the waterfall, okay? Ugh, villagers, they're so hard to manage. Alrighty. I'm trying to keep the episodes shorter, I've been running them at about 40, 45 minutes, and I realize that's a bit long. The boat just disappeared. You saw it. You saw it. I put the boat down, and it vanished. Minecraft be glitchy. So, been trying to keep the episodes, my plan is for the future to keep the episodes down to 20 minutes. So don't get any ideas. I don't even know where you think you're going, but don't go over there. All right, let's get in there and get out real quick. All right, so we need to block this area off. Let's mix it with mossy cobble. Oh, boat's back in my inventory again. Lovely. Okay. There we are. All caved in. Now where's the nitwit? This girl is all over the place. You are making me nervous, Elizabeth. Don't you want to come up here in the house? Sunset cannot come soon enough today. I don't know where Vincent is either. He's probably out on the porch. He's usually standing around out there. He's gotten out a couple of times in recent history. I've had to be very careful about opening these gates with him around, because he will just book and run right for him. Hey, Elizabeth. Hey. Hey, numbnuts. Why don't you come on over here? Come on over here. Come on. Come on. Come on. Up on the stairs. That a girl. Vincent's not here. Good. Keep going. You're doing good, Liz. You're doing good, Liz. Get right in there. Come on. Come on. Right through the gate. Right through the gate. Look at that. Look at that, dillweed. I didn't have to wait till night. Phew. Why don't you go say hi to Vince? That a girl. I don't think there are enough doors here for Vincent and Elizabeth to get it on and make baby villagers. But at least Vincent won't be alone now. And where the hell is he? There we go. There we go. Screenshot! Thanks, Vince. Well, Vincent is now no longer alone. He has a companion. He has someone to keep him company. We've provided for Vincent. We've given him sources of fresh water, food, meat, fish. We've decorated the environment around his house. I think we've done good work on this island. The question is, where should we go next? Pirates? Scientists? Or the ancient people who built the Moai? I gotta be honest, right now I'm leaning toward the people who made the Moai. Going off in that direction and seeing what we can find. I kinda like that idea. That sounds like there's a lot of possibilities for stories there. I think those people are still around, although they may not come out here anymore. Oop, there are ghosts. Forgot all about those. Well, no, I didn't. I think those people, I think that's what's interesting to me right now. And I really don't anticipate hearing from any of my viewers on the subject, but if someone has an idea for something else they'd like to see happen, let me know. So let's name those guys. All right, so we blocked off the entrance down there, but it's still accessible. You can get there by entering the sub bay and then going up the elevator shaft, or we can go down the mine drop. That's another way to get there. So let's do that. Let's get some name tags for Vincent's animals. So Vincent has two. How are you guys getting out of your pens? Glitchy, glitchy Minecraft. Fix your game, Mojang. Okay. So. Right. So we have two cows. I believe we have two sheep. I believe we have two pigs. Right? Where are those name tags? They're in here, aren't they? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, maybe? Whoa. Did you hear that? Timing is everything. I think there's a zombie villager in the mushroom patch. There is a baby zombie villager. And the question is, can we cure a baby zombie villager and then Vincent and Elizabeth actually have a baby? Do you believe this? Whoa. Oh, he's one angry little bugger, isn't he? Well, he might despawn. All right, let's see if we can do it. This was a surprise, but that's all right. I like surprises. Some of the time. We still have one more splash potion of weakness. We're going to need another golden apple. Drop it there to get him to come out. Hey, nut bar, come on out and get me. There we go. I get him. Got him and me. Great. Aha! You can cure a baby zombie. Okay. So, now, while he is being cured, we don't want anything else to spawn in there and kill him. So, let us fence that off. Put some light there. That should keep him safe. And let's name tag him. Great! Alright. How about I break that fence post? There he goes, he went right in the boat. So once he's cured, I can knock this wall out again, row him out there, and then break the boat, and he'll be free. Wow, I was not expecting that at all. That was weird. Oh, right, take the torch out, dum-dum. No, that's not where that goes. That is not where it goes. I have that swung the other way. I guess it doesn't matter. Hey, big guy. All right. So, names for the animals. Let's take care of that. Okay, so names for the animals. Let's take care of that. Okay. Alright, so let's see. We'll have Philippe. Naomi. Feathers. That can be one of the chickens, I guess. Ladybird. Oops. That can be the other chicken. Ladybird. How about Bartholomew? Let's see what else. Oh, Ricky. I don't know how many animals we actually have, so this may be overkill. We'll go back to it. We'll roll it back, you know. How about Penelope? That's a cute name. And Von Klaus. Okay, let's go name our eminals. To knock all this out. I'm gonna take this out too. Oh, our little villager baby is ready. Great. All right, let's just take him out here. Okay. Well, I guess Vincent and Elizabeth get to have one more companion. I think that's awesome. I think it's funny how that worked out. Okay. All right. Got our cave in all resituated. Now this guy is going to be all over the place. But at night he should run for the door. He's still Edward. Edward, Vincent, and Elizabeth. I better leave that campfire covered until we get Edward locked up in the house. There we go. That time the boat went down. Okay. All right, let's name the animals. Do we have eight animals? I think we do. Two chickens, two sheep, two cows, two pigs. Yeah, we do. All right, so one of the chickens was going to be Feathers, and the other one was going to be Ladybird. So, Eddie, if I open this gate, are you going to run in there like a jerk? Okay, good. All right, there's Feathers. Where's Ladybird? Ladybird. Feathers and Ladybird. All right, I think one of the pigs should be Bartholomew. Animals. Bartholomew the pig. I think Von Klaus should be the other pig. Very good. All right, Ricky can be the white sheep. And Penelope can be black sheep. Naomi can be one of the cows, and Philippe can be the other cow. Perfect. All right. All of the animals have names. You guys stay out of trouble. Now, where is Eddie? Eddie. Uh-oh. Eddie is small enough to wander under the house, just occurred to me. That sucks. Because he might actually try to go under there when it becomes night. We're going to have to try to herd him into the house like we did with the nitwit. And I don't know where he is. We gotta find him. Where'd you go, Edward? Oh, you checking out the dog? Hey, that sounds like a great idea. I want you to go up there, buddy. Come on, keep going. Keep going. That's a good boy. Come on, Eddie. Come on. Up the stairs. That's a good lad. Up you go. Don't be a dill hole. Get up there. Don't be a wiener. Okay, up. No. Vincent, you piece of poo. All right, Edward, can you get in there, please? Vincent. Okay, you don't need to do this, all right? I provided for you. You don't actually need to come down here and dork with the wheat, all right? You're not a farmer, okay? You're a shepherd. You can't make bread, okay? Vincent, you're not listening to me, are you? All right, well, we'll just have to wait till night, and then we can bundle Vincent into the house. At least Edward is in the house, or near the house. Yeah, I knew there was a risk of that. I think we should plant potatoes there anyway. Okay, well, we have provided for Vincent's family. And we've named all the animals. And I think it's time to draw this episode to a close. I really appreciate you joining me. I appreciate the time we've had together on our little tropical island. I'm sorry that I'm sort of running out of ideas for this particular location. And I invite you to, you know, make suggestions. But I guess that's it. And I think in the next episode, unless I hear from a significant number of people, I think we're going to set off in that direction. Which direction is that? East, toward the rising sun, to find the ancient people who built the Moai. I hope you'll stick with me, because I intend to keep going with this series. Yeah, I guess that's it. All right. No sense rattling on. Thank you for joining me. Bye-bye.